George is a most remarkable person, a model for what we would like our students to aim to become.
George is a person who dwells at the top because he's so damn smart.
It's quite remarkable. Almost as though he's been to the future and has just come back with the ideas that are there.
George came of a Greek immigrant family. He went to the Bronx High School of Science, where he graduated valedictorian, which is a common thing for George. Wherever he goes, he graduates first in his class. While there, he participated in the Westinghouse Science Talent Search and worked on a project that ultimately came in first. His life was changed. He decided that science would be the objective of all his work, and he committed himself to that. And so he went from Bronx Science to Columbia University, graduating valedictorian, Phi Beta Kappa, of course.
I could not have made a better decision. Going to Columbia in 1976 was a whole new beginning for me, a whole new set of eye-opening experiences that totally changed my life. For me, it really started with Professor Jonathan Greer, who was assigned to be my student advisor. He took me into his laboratory, doing real research, inspiring, but also really dedicated to me. I mean, it still amazes me looking back that he was taking the time to work with a first-year undergrad who knew nothing. It's the spirit of asking questions. It's the challenging, you know, the status quo, wondering about the science. If you ask questions to professors, and they may not have even thought about your question before, and say, you know, that's a great question. That's sort of the basis of promoting new thought and creativity.
George was the captain of the lightweight rowers in his senior year. He was as committed to that as he was to the research he did. He's remained a person who both has deep desire for intellectual life and also a deep connection to physical life as well.
Columbia is a very special place. I bleed lime blue. You have to remember, I didn't just go to Columbia College. I went to Columbia Medical School. I did my PhD at Columbia. I was a postdoc at Columbia. And I started a faculty job at Columbia. And I'm still on the adjunct faculty, so it's my school.
The luckiest moment of my professional career was being able to partner with George. I think one's individual character and values are really, really important. The most precious things to George in life are not the drugs that he's discovered, but are his children.
It's really remarkable that someone with the scientific talent that George displays is also able to run an enterprise. This is really special, because those are different talents.
When the science talent search was available, Regeneron took over and became the Regeneron Science Talent Search, and George was very much behind that.
When you are the product and the beneficiary of all these opportunities, it's really a duty and obligation to try to figure out how to do the same thing for others.
George understands that if we don't inspire and reward and nurture the next generation of scientists, it all stops. I can't think of anybody more deserving than the Alexander Hamilton Award than George Yancopoulos.